All right, y'all, we're gonna do a Zwift race. I'm gonna get a warm up in. We got 25 minutes. I'll warm up the legs and then I'm gonna hop back in and record so that you guys can see the race. We're gonna do downtown Dolphin today, I believe. Let me check. I hope you guys can hear me too, because I got my fan on. Same fan that was in the video where I show you guys how to do a beer budget pain cave setup. That's the fan I'm using. So drawback is it's a little loud, but it does the job, man. Yeah, we got downtown Dolphin today. 8 laps. This is usually full gas. It's only 4 people in the race right now, but let's see. I'm sure more people will sign up as it gets closer. But yeah, I'm gonna get warmed up because this is gonna be 8 hot laps, I already know. And then I'll start the camera so you guys can see the race. Also, I'm doing a race because I have an anaerobic workout on TrainerRoad, and I don't feel like doing that. So I might be actually racing this weekend, but I'm not sure yet. I'm building a new bike. I'll show you guys the bike that I'm building once it's done and all that. I just got a lot going on right now, and I'll tell you guys why more later on. But yeah, I'm doing the race today because I have an anaerobic workout on TrainerRoad, and it's only 30 minutes. And this race will probably be about 20 to 25 minutes max, so it fits into that ballpark. Let me turn this down, man. I'm watching Lantern Rouge. Lantern Rouge or Lantern Road? Anyway, I need to pick my bike. I think I'm on the S-Works. Let's see here. Yeah, Venge S-Works. Let's go a little bit deeper on the wheels just because it's basically a crit circuit. I like the A58s. I think the DT Swiss are supposed to be faster though. Let me know what you guys think. Pretty sure I ran. Actually, let me go back and do the DT Swiss because in my video with testing GP Llama's advice, I think I went with the A58s. So let's switch it up. Need to hurry up, the race is about to start. All right, we got DC Swiss on there. These always start full gas, so you gotta ramp it up. So usually I'll do the Zwift power check to see who I'm racing against, but this race is so small, man. I think we have 5, now it's 3 of us. Let's see if those riders can catch us. Otherwise, they're done. Throw seats at the wheel. So, somebody just quit. I saw that. We got 3. We got 4 of us up here. Try to get on this guy's wheel. He's hauling. So the thing with this race is gonna be even harder now because there's nowhere to really hide in the pack. And it's already 8 laps anyway, which is short. So we'll definitely get anaerobic in. If I can't get a podium out of this, y'all, I gotta go back to the drawing board. Change my camera. What camera angle do you guys run? I kind of like this one, so I can see how the gap looks. I don't think I only got 5-6 hours of sleep last night too. Coming up with the excuses already. My companion app ready. Don't do what I'm doing, y'all. Always have this stuff ready to go before your race starts, so you're not wasting energy. Eight more laps. That's seven. I'm gonna try to save this feather for either the last lap or when somebody launches a major attack in this group. I suspect it will come in the climb. Head start on it. Somebody's gonna attack. I think somebody's gonna go early, man. This is, if you haven't done an A race, they're pretty hard and sometimes can be very hard. Like normally, expect pretty hard, but on the worst days, very hard. These guys seem to be just biding their time. Just judging by the power that I'm putting in, putting down. I think maybe the next lap up. I think second to last lap. Somebody might try to go for a big flyer. I'm not complaining though. One tip, make sure you look at that sidebar, see what other riders are putting down for power. If you look at it right, you can see an attack coming before they pass you. Hope my trainer's not too loud for y'all. See if we get that heart rate back down on this flat. So you can see I got the draft, my rider's on the hoods. Now I don't have any draft anymore. See if I can get back into somebody's draft. There we go. Save some energy. Somehow the guy on the right's in a draft too. There goes the one I told y'all. Now expect to counter. Move up some. Another attack. Paying attention to the sideboard now. Easy draft here. Because I really want a feather for exactly what happened. speakers are playing around. That was a match, but fuck it. Excuse me. That was a match. Needed though. Two to go. Got a feather. Try to save it. Stay on. Italian guys will. We'll be right back.
want to watch Pink Kid? We'll watch everybody, but Pink Kid hasn't done anything all race. Whoa, that was hard. Wow. Y'all see, I had nothing left, man. 209 beats per minute, fair play. Oh man. Sorry, I didn't look at my power chart. So I'm gonna do just some cool down. I think that was 25 minutes. So I'm gonna get an hour of cool down. Easy cool down. I'll bring the power chart up so you guys can see. I think 209 was my max, but we'll see in the post ride. Man, the website, that's my cooldown. Here's the race. So I'm gonna look at my the chart for the race, and then we'll look at the Zwift power to see what official place we got. So the highest max heart rate, 209. That's what I thought. Then the sprint was 767, which is whatever. That's not the best sprint. All right, so we're in Zwift power. Go to results. That was the Rhino race, right? Yeah, there it is. And I got fourth, y'all. just off the podium out of six people though. So, man. Yeah, so like I said, those smaller races usually are hard. All right, so I brought you guys up so we can have the eye contact thing. Yeah, the smaller races, I feel like, are tougher. Sorry, just looking at the power. So we did 4.0 for 20 minutes. 1 minute, we did 5.4. 5 minutes, we did 4.4. So yeah, I feel like whenever you do a smaller Zwift race, it's always gonna be harder because you have to follow everything. Essentially, I think that when I closed that first move in the race, I was trying to sit on the guy's wheel. Forget his name, but sit on his wheel to make him close it, but he wasn't. So the Italian guy was off the front. And at that point, I mean, we raced to try to win. So I know my power profile to jump across. I could jump across at that moment, so I did. But that was a huge match. And basically the guy who was next to me that didn't close it just sat on my wheel and took the free ride. But that's why I like Zwift racing, because you have to practice these racing tactics and techniques. And that's transferable to real life racing. But yeah, that's it. I'll try to do another Zwift race soon. Let me know in the comments, guys, if you guys like this type of content, just trying something new out. Thanks for watching.